This is the home of Vice President Hubert Humphrey in Rock Creek Park, Washington. And this is a typical day in the life of Mr. Humphrey. It starts early and energetically. Even the family dog gets in the act as another busy day begins. At 55, our nation's number two man is in good physical condition. And as these scenes prove, he likes nothing better than a brisk walk, setting a rapid pace for his companions. 6 hours of sleep each night is the Vice President's usual quota, and his list of daily duties keeps him constantly on the move. Beneath his official seal, the Vice President expedites a mountain of paperwork each day, maintaining a huge correspondence with a wide range of people, from citizens to chiefs of state. Frequent appearances, such as this one at the FBI Academy graduation with J. Edgar Hoover, are also normal and routine for a vice presidential day. Travel, of course, is mandatory, and Mr. Humphrey makes extensive use of aircraft, but the constant press of duty continues, even in flight. In Atlantic City, a large crowd greets the Vice President. Mr. Humphrey is here for one of his many speaking appearances. A longtime favorite of labor groups, he's in the resort city to address the Amalgamated Clothing Workers of America convention. During his address, Mr. Humphrey called for a national drive against slums, commented on the Vietnamese War, and closed his day as he started it with energetic enthusiasm.